In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create and animate this cubic title animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll create a cube out of 3D layers, animate it, and then make a title animation out of it without using any plugins. Stick around till the end. First of all, let's create a new comp, obviously. We name it Cube, 1080 by 1080 pixels, 72 frames long. Then we grab the rectangle tool and double click on it to create a shape layer. We open the rectangle path property and set the size to 300 by 300 pixels. No stroke. Let's add a gradient fill. Going from a red to some kind of orange-yellow color. Let's quickly adjust the direction of the gradient, dragging the two blue points. And we name the shape front. Next, we turn it into a 3D layer by activating this little cube here. Then we go over here to the right corner of the viewport and set the view layout to two views. Now we see the active camera and the top view, which is very convenient. We open the anchor point property of the shape and set the set value of the anchor point to 150, half the size of the shape. That's the middle point of the cube. We duplicate the shape, name it back, and set the Y rotation to minus 180 degrees. Let's use a solid color though, and change the fill into a dark purple. We duplicate the back layer, name it left, open the rotation property and set the Y rotation to 90 degrees. We duplicate the left layer, turn it into the right side, Y rotation minus 90 degrees. We duplicate the right layer, turn it into the bottom, we set X to 90 degrees. And the top, X 270 degrees. That's all the six shapes of our cube. Now we grab the title tool and add a letter to the front. Any kind of font works. I prefer a clean one with a bold or even heavy font style. Then we turn it into a 3D layer and it disappears because it's inside the cube. So we need to change the set position value to minus 151, one pixel closer to the camera than the shape. Now we add an adjustment layer, name it rotation. Select all the other layers and link them to the new adjustment layer. This allows us to easily rotate the cube in any direction. It needs to be a 3D layer, of course. Awesome. You might see these little slots here at the edges, like the cube is not completely closed. Why is that, Adobe? To get rid of them, you might want to increase the size of the shapes by 1 or 2 pixels. 301 or 302 pixels altogether. Awesome! Let's animate the cube. We set a keyframe for the X rotation at the beginning. Then let's turn the front to the back. X is minus 180 degrees. At 4 frames, it rotates back even further, to around minus 190 degrees. At 15 frames, the front is back in front of the camera, around 40 degrees. At 20 frames, it has bounced back to minus 15 degrees. At 24 frames, it has moved back in the other direction, 10 degrees. At 28 frames, it is minus 5 degrees. At 31 frames, it is finally zero. Let's check it out. Still a bit rough. So let's select all keyframes and open the graph editor. Make sure Snap is activated and Edit Speed Graph is selected. Then we grab the points, move them to the zero line, one after the other. Adjust the handles and create this nice speed curve. The nicer the curve looks, the smoother the animations. Seriously. Awesome. Looks smooth to me. One last thing we could do, if you wanted to, is add a gradient ramp to all the purple shapes. Let's quickly set the start and end point. Add lots of ramp scatter. Then let's choose a very dark purple. The second color even darker, almost black. Actually, let's brighten up the first color a little bit. Adjust the points a little more. Nice. Let's copy it and paste the effect to all the other purple shapes. Better, right? The best would be to quickly hit the like button if you enjoy the video so far. Thanks very much, guys. Now, let's create a new comp. 1920 by 1080 pixels this time, and let's name it Title Animation. Then we copy. Did you know that if you select your layers from the bottom to the top, copy them and paste them to a new comp, the order of the layers is reversed? We don't want that, so we select all layers beginning from the top, copy them and paste them to the new comp. Then we hide this little guy here for the six shape layers. It's called the Shy Switch, not for the adjustment layer and the text layer though. You'll soon see why. Then we quickly change the label color of the layers to red. We select all layers, duplicate them, move them to the top and choose a new label color. And repeat that until we have the amount of letters we need. In this case, it's 5 letters. Then we activate the Shy Switch. And a lot of layers disappear, which is awesome, we don't need them. Next, we select all the adjustment layers. Open the scale properties and scale the cubes down to 75%. Then we position the cubes next to each other, starting with the top one. Then we move the second cube next to the first one, and so on. It looks weird because the first and the second cube are sticking out. They are on top in the layer hierarchy, so we need to move them down. We move the second cube below the third one. And the first cube below the second one. Awesome. Let's hide all these layers again. Now we need to offset the rotation animations. We select all the rotation layers and press U to see the keyframes in the timeline. And move the keyframes to the right. The first one, that's all right. The second one, we select all keyframes and move them 4 frames to the right. The third cube, 8 frames. And so on. Let's check it out. Looks great. We actually haven't replaced the letters yet. So let's do that quickly. And we should adjust the gradient ramps. At least some of them. One last thing we could do is add another adjustment layer. Let's name it Perspective. We make it a 3D layer and link all the rotation layers to it. Then let's open the rotation property and slightly change the rotation. 3D in After Effects is always a bit tricky. As you can see, with the change of perspective, we need to move the first two cubes up again. Awesome. That's how I would create an animated cube in After Effects. Another option would be to do it in 3D, like in Blender or Cinema 4D, of course. Would you prefer creating it in 3D? Let me know in the comments below. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Please hit the like button, and you might want to subscribe for new and original animation and motion design videos every week. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I really appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye!